Okay, let's review order of operation. Remember some time ago in your mathematical career, a teacher referred to order of operation using the term PEMDAS or please excuse me, dear Aunt Sally. I'd just like to review over that to make sure that we have the proper order before we get into the order of operation problems. Remember that P stands for parentheses, and anything in parentheses needs to be done first. And then if we have any exponents or square roots, like 2 to the third or the square root of 4, we'll do those next. In the past, many students thought that multiplication came ahead of division, and so I've written it this way to let you know that both multiplication and division are equals, and they should be done in a problem as they come from left to right. And then the lowest level of order of operation is our addition and subtraction. They too are equals and should be done from left to right as they come in the problem. Now, before we start working any order of operation, let's just go back and review a minute our exponents. Example, 5 squared, if you remember, is not 5 plus 5. It's not 5 times 2, is 10. 5 squared means 5 times 5. So 5 times 5 is 25. And then on this one, a negative 3 to the third, you know what that means. It means a negative 3 times a negative 3 times a negative 3. And you remember from multiplication and division of integers that when you have an odd number of negatives, your answer will be negative. So I know it's going to be negative. 3 times 3 is 9, and 9 times 3 is 27. So the answer is a negative 27. On the fraction one, we know that that is supposed to be 2/6 times 2/6. So I'll write 2/6 times 2/6. And when you multiply, 2 times 2 is 4. And 6 times 6 is 36. Another way to look at it would be take each number and treat it like a whole number. 2 squared is 4. And 6 squared is 36. And then our last one. Negative 1/4 to the third is negative 1/4 times negative 1/4 times negative 1/4. Once again, we have 3 negatives, an odd number of negatives, so we know the answer is going to be a negative. And if we multiply the top, we're going to have 1 times 1 times 1, which is a negative 1. And 4 times 4 is 16, and 16 times 4 is 64. But the answer is a negative 1 over 64. You could also multiply the negative 1 to the square root of 3, which will be a negative 1, and 4 to the square root of 3, which will be 64. Okay? All right, now let's do some order of operation problems. We'll start easy and get a little more difficult each time. Okay, let's start with this one. Let's do 4 squared minus 2 times 3. Okay, now what needs to be done first? We don't have any parentheses, but we do need to begin with the squaring. So I'm going to do 4 squared, which is 16. I'm going to rewrite the problem for you so you can see each part, minus 2 times 3. Now the second thing we need to do is not subtract. We need to multiply 2 times 3. So 2 times 3 is 6, and I'll rewrite the problem again, 16 minus 6. And now we're ready to finish it up. 16 minus 6 is 10. So we started with our exponents, then we did our multiplication, and then we finished up with subtraction. That was pretty good, wasn't it? All right, let's go for our next one. Let's try 50. Divided by 5 minus 3. Well, we have a division and a subtraction. So let's divide first. 50 divided by 5 is 10. I'll write 10 minus 3, and 10 minus 3 is 7. So our answer on this one is 7. Division first, followed by subtraction. All right, now this time I'm going to give you one that uses absolute value. Remember, absolute value is how many jumps back to zero. It's always positive unless there's a negative sign waiting outside the bars. All right, I'm going to go absolute value of a negative 4 plus 12 plus 2. So the first thing I want to do is I want to solve anything in absolute value. Then I want to bring the answers out. So there's nothing to solve on this one. So the absolute value of a negative 4 is 4. So I'll put my 4. And I'm going to solve this one. 12 plus 2 is 14. And it will come out as a positive 14. And then there's a plus sign between them. So 4 plus 14 is 18. Remember, if I had had a negative right here, it would have come out as a positive, and then I'd have to change it back to a negative. But in this case, it wasn't. Okay? All right, let's try another one. I'd like to try this one using some parentheses and some brackets. I'd like to do 2, and I'm going to have 5 divided by 3 plus 2. Okay, now remember we said we're going to start with parentheses first. So I'm going to begin with 3 plus 2 so I can remove the parentheses, and then I'll be moving up to the next level, which will be the brackets. All right, 3 plus 2 is 5. So now I have 5 divided by 5, and then I have 2 outside, and that 2 is hugging the bracket, and that hugging means to multiply. But before we do that, we need to go ahead and take care of what's inside the brackets. 5 divided by 5 is 1. Now, you can keep the brackets, but if you take the brackets off, you better put a multiplication sign between the 2 and the number 1, because that 2 hugging means 2 times 1. So 2 times 1 is 2, and the answer is 2. Okay? All right, now this time, I am going to give you, I'm going to give you some values for the variables in the problems that I present to you, and we're going to see if we can solve them. Let me give you an example. Let's say that I'm going to tell you that when you see x, I want x to be equal to 3, and when you see y, I want it to be equal to 2. So let me give you a problem. Keep in mind order of operation, okay? All right, here we go. X plus 2y in parentheses squared. Now we're going to sub in those values, but we also have to use order of operation. So first I'm going to sub in the values. Here we go. X is 3 plus 2 times 2 and 3 plus 4 is equal to 7. Now we have 7 in parentheses, which needs to be squared, because we wait to do the square after we've done what's in parentheses. So that's 7 squared, and 7 squared is 49. So we subbed in the x and y value in the problem. We used order of operation to complete our assignment. Okay, let's try another one. How about this time I'm going to let x be, say, 4. And I want y to be 2. All right, let's try this one. 5x minus 2y over 8. Okay, you ready to sub in the x and the y? Okay, here we go. 5 times x means 5 times 4 minus 2 times, what's y? 2, okay. All right, that looks good so far. And then, of course, we have that over 8. Now, let's see. 5 times 4 is 20. And 2 times 2 is 4. So that's 20 minus 4 over 8. And 20 minus 4 is 16. And that leaves us with 16 over 8, which we can reduce because it is an improper fraction to the whole number 2. So how'd that go? Pretty good at subbing in? All right, well, let's try a little more difficult one then. Okay, this time I'm going to let x be 2, y is going to be 1, and z will be 4. Okay, are you ready? I'm going to go x over 2y plus 2. Okay, here we go. We have an x on top and a 2y plus 2 on the bottom. All right, x is equal to 2. And on the bottom, 2 times y, 2 times 1 is 2, and 2 plus 2. So now we have 2 over 4. We could leave it that way, but most of the time you're going to want to reduce, and you know that 2 will go into both 2 and 4. So 2 fourths is equal to 1 half, and you have just evaluated my problem for me by subbing in those values. Okay, I think we shall try another one using those same values. Okay, I'm going to hit you up with absolute value again. Okay, here we go. I'm going to put a negative on the outside, and I'm going to say 4z minus 3y. Okay, now what are we going to do first? First, we're going to sub in the values for 4z minus 3y and totally solve that. Then we'll address the negative out here. Okay, what is 4 times z? 4 times 4 is 16, minus 3 times 1 is 3. So that's what we have so far. 16 minus 3 is 13. It's still an absolute value with a negative sign on the outside. Now we're totally finished with the problem. We just need to bring it out of absolute value and then apply the negative sign. So the absolute value of 13 is 13. I bring it out, I must apply the sign, and our answer is down negative 13. That go pretty well for you? I hope so. All right, and now let's see what we've got here. Let's try our last one. I think I'll keep it, let's keep x is 2, y is 1, and z is 4. I didn't mean to erase that. Okay, pretty easy one here. I'm going to go 3z squared. Now, there's a mistake that a lot of students make. Are you going to be one of those? I hope not. Remember that 3z means 3 times z, and z squared means z times z. Now, what comes first in order of operation? The exponents come first, that's right. So I'm going to begin with z squared, and z squared is 4 times 4. So let me put 4 squared. So we have 4 squared, which we'll take care of, and then we're going to multiply by 3. 4 squared is 16. That 3 is hugging, so that means multiply, and 3 times 16 is 48. All right, so in this lesson we've done order of operation. We have evaluated some algebraic expressions and used different values for x, y, and z to see if you can solve. Good job. We'll move on to our next video.